Hello everyone. In this video, we will discuss about the key responsibilities of a teacher. Before discussing the responsibility of a teacher, we should know the role and contribution of a teacher to the society and to the nation. So without further ado, let's get started. Teaching is a timeless profession. It is the basis of all other professions. Teachers are one of the main pillars of a sound and progressive society. Good teachers plant seed that make good doctors, good accountants, and good scientists. Teachers bear the weight and responsibility of teaching, and apart from parents, are the main source of knowledge and values for future generation. The importance of a teacher as an architect of our future generation demands that only the best, the most intelligent, the most competent member of the society be allowed to qualify for the noble profession. For the development of such teachers, the society should look towards the great masters and teachers of the society who has thrown light on the development of teachers. India has given many such thinkers, philosophers and teachers who devoted their lives for education. Now we will discuss the role of a teacher. Educational process mainly consists of three poles: student, teacher and parents. The teacher plays the pivotal role in the chariot of education. A teacher plays various roles during teaching learning process to fill responsibilities assigned to them. Teachers are like gardeners. The students are like rosebud plants. The teacher is like a friend, philosopher and a guide for the students. Some of the roles of the teachers are as follows: judge action and correct them and don't calling them according to tradition, convention according to so-called morality. According to the teacher's prejudices, the role of a teacher is similar to judge. If teachers see that something is wrong and will destroy that person's intelligence, teacher should correct the action of a student. So teacher needs to be aware and neutral when he passes any judgment. Put the students on the right path through compassion and love. Third, channelize the energy of the students. The students are with full of energy. It is the nature of energy that it cannot be destroyed. So the role of a teacher is to know the best way to channelize the energy. A guide to show the right channel. Now the role of a teacher are no more just teachers, but they are guides, helper and facilitators. In the age of technology, the role of a teacher as technology friendly is required. A guide to find the latest information on the subject. Sixth, learn from students. The difference between the teacher and the taught has to be resolved. They are the part of one process. Teacher should change the role with the student one in a while and see the whole process from others' perspective, which bring changes in the whole education system. Arise dormant questioning in children, awaken inquisitiveness and themselves. 8. Help students' doubt disappear and make them more knowledgeable. Listen the student patiently. Patience is very much required for the profession of a teacher. 10th, help the students to be more creative. The real teacher does not inform, but he transforms. A real teacher is one who uses the all kinds of living situation to provoke awareness in students. Discipline the students, keeping in mind one thing: the discipline is a means, freedom is the end. Teacher's responsibilities. A painter works on a canvas, a dead thing with dead colors. A scientist works on object. A doctor works on dead limbs, dissecting bodies, treating illness. A teacher works on consciousness, on alive people. His canvas is life, and certainly whatsoever he creates, tremendous value. So teacher has tremendous responsibilities to fulfill. All the great people of the world, like Socrates, Christ, Buddha, are the teachers. We have forgotten the fact that only teachers have given beautiful things to the world. This can happen when the teachers are aware about their responsibilities. Now, one by one, we will discuss the responsibilities of a teacher. First, put the student on the right path. Second, take the work as a service, a prayer, a worship. Third, should not categorize the students. Fourth, should come down to level, stand their problem. Fifth, give the children curiosity, thirst for knowing. Sixth, help the students to be themselves. Seventh, help the students with new answer and new knowledge. Eighth, produce a temperament which can jump into unknown. Ninth, think what and how he can do good for child. 10th, make students aware of the contemporary knowledge of the latest knowledge. 11th, create trust in students. 12th, draw out what is in student. Now, I will end this video. Thank you and have a nice day.